Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with a new art journal layout. Today I'll be using a new product which is called Infusions by Paper Archie. These are colored stains or paint in powder form. A lot of people like to use a poke tool and make some hole or more smaller holes on the top of the lid, but I don't really like this method. I prefer to apply my powder with just a tip of a dry brush. I'm going to demonstrate how I work with them. But that's up to you. You can always make it look like a salt and pepper jar. Now I am just applying a little bit of that powder, and I am going to spray it with water because that's how you activate that powder. And you will see that this powder is a mix of many colors. There are two different colors plus a brown one. And since all the infusion jars have a little bit of brown in them, they are perfect for vintage projects. And depending on the look you are going for, you can leave it as it is now with all those little splashes, or you can go heavy with water and you can see what happens. Now I am going to show you many different techniques on how to work with them today, and I am going to do all the coloring on my art journal today just with infusions. With a dry brush, I am applying some infusions powder on my page, and you can see on screen right now the two colors that I am using. A little goes a long way, and I have probably used too much here, but it's going to work out fine. Now you can spray with water, just a little bit, and leave it as it is, nice and vibrant, but I am going to spray a lot since I am going for a watercolor look. So I'm going to close my pages now and transfer the paint to the other page as well. And just because I have a ton of water, I'm going to use a paper towel to clean things up, and I'm also going to use a cardstock in between the pages to get all that excess water. So once that's done, I am going to use my heat gun and make sure that everything is nice and dry. And if you want to make sure that no water is going to go through that fold to the other projects, you can always use, before you start, a piece of masking tape in the middle. I am also working on my Dilutions art journal that takes water and mediums really well. So what is great about these are that they react with water when they dry. So I get the chance to make lots of fun techniques. So I'm using a Paper Archie stencil, and with a baby wipe I am going over the stencil and remove some of the paint. So I get this great effect, which is called ghosting. And now I am going to seal everything down. So if you want to seal your pages, you can always use a thick gel medium, like I'm doing here. I am applying it with a dry brush, so I'm not adding any water at all at the moment, and that is why my paint doesn't react. So once I seal down one page, I'm going to do the exact same thing on the other page. And now everything is dry and sealed down. To make my background more interesting, I am going to use this stamp set, which is by Paper Archie, and I'm going to stamp a few of those stamps. So I'm starting with the text, and I'm going to use a green archival ink for that. So I'm stamping randomly all over the page, and I'm not making sure that everything is stamped perfectly. I don't really mind, I just need another layer on top of my previous ones. There is also a nice word that says bloom on this stamp set, which I'm also going to stamp with the same archival ink. So at this stage I'm really happy with how my background looks, and I'm going to clean up my stamps, put them back together, and I'm going to go ahead and work on my focal points. So for my focal points I'm going to make some flowers, and to do so I want to stamp and cut them out of some paper. So you can see how I'm working with my infusions now. I want to have everything sealed down so it doesn't react with water. So first I have applied a little bit of powder, and applied it not with water but with gel medium. So everything is sealed down and it doesn't react with water now. I can make it even more vibrant if I apply more paint on top. And I can dry everything with my heat gun. And just to have different options for my flowers, I'm going to repeat the same process with more colors on some more paper scraps. And you can see the difference. When you spray with water, you get all those different colors and all that crazy look. But when you apply the powder with the gel medium, everything is so much more controlled, and you can really make so many different techniques with them. I am applying again with my gel medium, and you can use any gel medium that you have at home or even a glaze. You can use a satin glaze or something glossy that will give a nice shimmer on your pages. I continue to do the same thing again and again with different colors, and as I'm doing so, just to let you know that there are 12 different colors of those infusions, but they are not released yet. This is a new collection by Paper Archie. These are going to be released really soon, and you will be able to find them in your favorite shops. And as always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area. And I will make sure to update the supply list once everything is released. I found out about those new infusions while I was visiting Paris for a craft show which is called Version Scrap. And I am going to share a different video with a quick tour of their booth showing all the products. So I am now going to go ahead and stamp those flowers, and I really love those flowers because they are so whimsical. I'm using black archival ink, and I'm going to stamp those two different flowers on all my four different shades of colors. I plan to use my scissors and cut out all the flowers, and I am going to make the most out of those scraps, so I'm going to stamp again and again in order to have many different options. I have all my little pieces ready to go, and now it's time to stamp the flowers directly on my page. To stamp the flowers, I'm using black archival ink, which is permanent and it's not going to react when I stick everything down with my gel medium. I am stamping everything directly, although I have cut out the flowers, just because I need the stems. And as you can see, since I'm working on a bulky book, sometimes it's difficult to stamp with the acrylic block, so I'm just choosing to stamp with my fingers. I'm going to try and do all those randomly, making sure that I switch the angles of stamping so that they look more organic and not so repetitive. And now it's time to place all the flowers and decide where everything is going to go. I'm trying to switch between colors, so not two same colors are next to each other for a nice variety. So here I am ready to stick everything down, but then I realized that I had this beautiful border on this same stamp set, and I wanted to add that border around my page to frame it. So that's what I'm doing now, and I chose to do that now before sticking the flowers down, since I wanted to stick some of the flowers over the border for a nice touch. So again, I'm using my black archival ink, and I'm using that border stamp all around. I am using my white gel pen to color the border, and this is going to give a nice touch to my page. You will see how it's going to change everything at the end. Now, it was taking me forever using this pen, since it has such a fine tip, but if you go ahead and do that, you can always use your brush with white acrylic paint or gesso, or you can even use a thick marker like I switched doing here. So now I'm ready to stick everything down by using my gel medium. As I'm drying my gel medium, you can see that I have some of the leaves over the border for a nice touch. And also you might notice that there are actually leaves for some of those flowers coming out of those stems, but I chose to color them different colors than green just because I have a green background. I really love how all those flowers pop from the page, and I think that all those colors are just beautiful together. So I'm adding some white touches with my gel pen, and I'm also going to use a green marker to color the stems as well as add even more highlighting. So here is how the layout looks right now, and you can call it done, but if you want to take it a step further, you can add some shading on the flowers and make them look more three-dimensional. To do so, I'm going to use my distress crayon, and you can see how easy it is. I'm just applying at the bottom of the flower a little bit of that crayon and smudge it with my finger. You can do that on all the flowers by using a slightly darker shade of crayon than the actual flower. To finish off my layout, I'm going to stamp my quote that says, "The earth loves in flowers." This is a stamp from the same stamp set by Paper Archie that I have used earlier for my background. I have stamped the quote by using Versamark ink, and now I'm going to apply white embossing powder. And since my embossing powder was stuck in places I didn't want to, I have used a nice soft brush to make sure that it's nice and clean all over. And now I can go ahead and use my heat gun to set the powder. And just because I can never stop doing finishing touches, I decided to make those bubbles on the background even more defined with my white gel pen. So that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the project today. Oh, and if you loved this project, don't forget to share it with your friends. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more art journal layouts that I made a while back. Thank you all for watching!